In Twiddle, we're trying to optimize for a set of parameters. To do so, our function run must return a goodness. This goodness value might be the average crosstag error. So I want you to implement Twiddle so as to minimize the average crosstag error. If that's the case, then the output of run depends on the three parameters. So here's how Twiddle works. Build a parameter vector of our three target parameters and initialize it with zero. Also, build a vector of potential changes that you want to probe and initialize them for now with one. Then you can run our command run with our parameters, and whatever it outputs is our best error so far. So now we wish to modify p as to make the error smaller, and that's where Twiddle comes in. It's a really smart algorithm, I believe. We sequentially go through these parameters. Obviously, you shouldn't write 3, you should write len of p. And first, we try to increase p by our probing value, compute a new error for this new modified p. If this new error is better than our best error, then we do two things. First, we set best error to error, and we even modify our dp to a slightly larger value by multiplying it with 1.1. Otherwise, we try the other way. So we subtract dp from p, and we have to do it twice now because we added it before. And then we do the same thing again as over here. I'm not going to write it out, but we check whether the error is better than our best error, and then we retain it, and we multiply dp up by 1.1. But if both of those fail, this one over here and this one over here, we set back pi to the original value, and we decrease our probing thing over here. Say we're multiplying it with 0.9. That's the core of Twiddle. And what it really does is it, for each coordinate in isolation, moves our parameter up or down a little bit by this value over here. If it then finds a better solution, it retains it, and it even increments the probing interval. But if it fails to find a better solution, it goes back to the original and decreases our probing interval. We do this entire thing so long as the sum of the dps is larger than the threshold. So somewhere in here we say while sum of dp is larger than 0.00001. It's hard to read, but I hope you could follow it. This is Twiddle. So let me put this into pictures. We have three parameters, 0, 0, 0. And then in the first iteration, we bump one of the parameters up and see if it improves the error. If that's the case, we retain it. Then we go to the second parameter, we bump it up, it might not work. We bump it down, maybe we retain that one, and so on. And now as we keep bumping up, we might find that neither bumping up nor bumping down helps. So we do instead is we retain the original solution, but make our probing interval smaller than before by a factor of 0.9. In doing so, we can zoom in more and more into a detailed parameter until it finally converges. It's a local hill climber, but it happens to be really, really efficient.